80s dated furniture. What can you do with this stuff? Well, don't throw it away. Let me show you how to make it so much better. Hey guys, I'm Kira with Lemons to Lemonade Furniture, and I found this dated disaster on Facebook Marketplace. And if there's anything that I love to flip, it's 80s furniture. So I'm gonna show you how to recreate this one with the trending colors for 2024, and I'm gonna show you how to make a little bit of profit on this along the way. Let's go.
My starting piece today is a laminate dresser from the 1980s. I picked this up on Facebook Marketplace for 60 bucks. It's pretty banged up, like you can see on the outsides, but actually the drawers are in really good shape and there are no major repairs to be done on this dresser. It is totally laminate 80s style furniture, so my hope today is to show you how you can make this into so much more. Stay tuned.
The hardware on these are absolutely perfect. I'm definitely going to be reusing these for this project, so now I just need to get them all off of here and get this project cleaned.
This hardware is perfect for what I have in mind for this dresser, so I'll get these taken off, and I always put all of the hardware in a little storage compartment so that I can make sure I can find everything when it's time to put it back on. I've got my Simple Green out to give this dresser a good clean. As you can tell, it's really gross and dirty on the outside. And the paint that I'm using today calls for a good TSP cleanser so that the paint will adhere nicely. So I'm gonna make sure and take my time and make sure this guy is squeaky clean before I start painting. The top was extra sticky, so I got out my drill attachment brush to make sure I got all of the goopy stuff off the top. Everything I'm using today is going to be listed in the video details below, so be sure to check that out if you have any questions. I'm pulling my dresser all apart to see if there's anything lurking on the inside, and as I suspected, it is full of dust bunnies. So I'll get my vacuum out and make sure that all of these are gone. It's so important if you're gonna sell furniture that you do these extra steps. I mean, it's important anyways, especially if you're gonna put it back in your home, but you never want your clients to go home with this icky stuff. Now I need to smooth the surface of this dresser. I'm using my orbital sander and 120 grit sanding paper. This dresser has some really deep gouges on the top, and I'm gonna try to get rid of those with the sander first. I'm wiping back all my sanding dust, and unfortunately, a lot of those deep gouges have not gone away, so we're gonna have to move on to option number two to fix those. I've grabbed my wood fill, and I'm gonna push some of this into all those deep gouges. There's like one long scratch that's across the top of these that needs to be fixed, so I don't need a whole ton of this. So as I go and I've got it shoved into there pretty well, I'll be sure to scrape off all the extra. That just means that I won't have a ton of sanding to do once this is dry. While I wait for the wood fill to dry, I'm going to do a scuff sand on the rest of the dresser. I'm using my 3x4 orbital sander. It is perfect to get on these rounded curves and edges of this dresser, and also into all the edges of the drawers.
Thank you. I've got the top sanded down. Everything is nice and smooth, but I am going to apply a coat of clear shellac to this top because when I sanded it, I exposed more of that particle board that's underneath. And I'm going to be using a water-based product today. I'm going to be using milk paint. So I don't want any of that particle board to expand, to bleed through, or to just leave a weird texture on top of my paint. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to seal that up with some clear shellac.
For today's piece, I'm going to be using the Real Milk Paint in the color Navy Blue. The milk paint formula is made with 100% organic ingredients. It's non-toxic, VOC-free, and even biodegradable. Milk paint is fume-free so that you can paint indoors if you need to, and it creates a beautiful matte finish. Milk paint is so easy to mix up. The bag comes inside of this can with a marble that you'll drop in, and then you just measure out equal parts powder paint to equal parts water and make sure you give it a good shake. This is a fairly large dresser, so I'm going to start with 1 cup of milk paint powder to 1 cup water.
If you've ever used milk paint before, you know that it can have a chippy effect that you cannot control. So if you do not want it to chip, you'll mix in something like Ultra Bond. So I'm going to use milk paint's Ultra Bond today in this navy blue milk paint because I do not want this to chip. I want it to go on smooth and not have any surprises with the chipping.
I want a look that's free of brush strokes, so I'm going to use a foam roller to apply my milk paint today.
I was up late burning the midnight oil, but I knew this thing was gonna take one more coat of paint. So I've done 3 coats total now, and it is absolutely beautiful. It is this gorgeous, like, bluish indigo color. I know it's not gonna stay. As soon as I add the wax to seal this, it's gonna turn into navy blue, but it's so pretty and rich and deep. It's beautiful. It's really coming along.
To seal this piece, I've chosen to use the Real Milk Paint's wood wax. It is all natural, food safe wax made completely with plant-based ingredients. Again, it's VOC free and contains no mineral oils or solvents. It's perfect for sealing over the Real Milk Paint and leaving you with that beautiful matte finish. Most of my returning viewers know that I just absolutely love repurposing and flipping 80s furniture. Is there a style decade that you just love to flip to the latest trends, or one that you'd like to see me flip in the future? Let me know in the comments below.
I remember from the beginning that my drawers don't slide very well, so I'm going to use some of my wax while I've got this out and go along the insides of the drawer glides so that my drawers will slide nicely when I put them back in.
And I just couldn't leave well enough alone on this guy, so I'm going to give this dresser some extra height and dimension with a furniture base. I did not show how I built this base in this video. However, I have built plenty of these in the past, and I will link those videos below that have a step-by-step guide. And I must give credit to the original furniture base creator, DIY Wife. I've got her video linked below as well. I'm using a Minwax stain in the color Espresso to give this base a little moodier feel to match with the navy blue dresser. I'm using a foam brush to apply it. I'll let it sit for just a little bit and then I'll wipe back any extra that's on the surface.
You remember the handles from the beginning, I'm going to definitely be reusing these, but I need to get off the orange finish, so let's sand these down.
I'm using my Surfprep 3x4 raised sander with the squishy foam abrasive pad on this. This will help make sure that I don't accidentally sand off any of those rounded edges and curves. And now that I have the handles down to bare wood, I'm going to use that same Espresso stain from Minwax to make sure that the base and the handles are the same color. I've got my helper out in the garage. He's going to help me tip this thing over so we can put the base on. To seal the base and the handles, I'm using the Real Milk Paint's Dark Half. Dark Half adds depth to the grain to instantly give it a nice aged look. It's a blend of dark tung oil and citrus solvent, and I'll apply it with a lint-free cloth and let it soak in for a bit before I wipe off any extra. Wow, you guys, what do you think of the transformation of this 80s dresser? I am all in on this inky blue matte milk paint. I absolutely love it. Thank you so much, The Real Milk Paint, for sponsoring this video. And be sure to check out The Real Milk Paint's website in my description box below. And you can see all of their 56 beautiful colors that they offer in this matte finish, as well as the waxes and the oils that I used on today's project. You guys want to try this out, trust me. Selling points for this one, I'll be listing it on Facebook Marketplace for around $800. That's the going price right now in my area. I've got about $380 all in on this project with my supplies and the purchase of the dresser. So if I can sell it for around $800, that's a pretty good profit for 2 days' work. Thank you all so much for being here. I look forward to seeing you next week with another great flip. And in the meantime, be sure to hit that subscribe, like, follow, and hit that notification bell so you never miss a flip. See you next time.